The F-104 Starfighter was a revolutionary aircraft that redefined the possibilities of high-altitude flight during the Cold War era. Developed by the American aerospace company Lockheed, the F-104 was designed to serve as an interceptor and tactical fighter aircraft for the United States Air Force and its NATO allies. First flown in 1954, the F-104 Starfighter was widely known for its distinctive shape and advanced design, including a slender fuselage, short wings, and a pointed nose that gave it a futuristic appearance. Nicknamed the missile with a man in it, the F-104 was also equipped with a powerful engine to reach speeds of Mach 2.2 and altitudes of over 100,000 feet. But while its speed and agility made it an effective interceptor, the F-104 was also notoriously difficult to fly and suffered a high accident rate, earning it a reputation as a widowmaker. Despite its controversial legacy, it remains an iconic symbol of Cold War-era aviation technology. Kelly Johnson. Kelly Johnson, by name of Clarence Leonard Johnson, was an innovative American aeronautical engineer and designer. He studied at the University of Michigan before beginning his career with the Lockheed Corporation in 1933. As head of Skunk Works, Lockheed's secret development unit, Johnson would eventually design more than 40 aircraft, many of which were used during the World War II period, such as the P-38 Lightning, the P-80 Shooting Star Jet Fighter, and the C-69 Constellation. Johnson also went on to design the U-2 spy plane, the first aircraft to fly above 60,000 feet, and the fastest and most iconic aircraft of the Cold War, the legendary SR-71 Blackbird, made entirely of aluminum. Following World War II, aircraft designers departed from the traditional lightweight fighter design and opted for bulkier designs that could carry heavier payloads and fly longer distances. Kelly Johnson did something different and went the other way around. In November 1951, 1 year after the outbreak of the war between North and South Korea, Johnson visited several U.S. bases to speak with seasoned fighter pilots. Many of them were veterans from the previous war and provided him with valuable information about their combat experience and what they wanted or needed in a new fighter aircraft to even the odds against the latest Soviet jet-powered fighter, the Mikoyan-Gurievich MiG-15 Fagot. The Starfighter. The MiG-15 was small, fast, and agile in combat. Some American fighters aboard F-86 Sabres had already engaged it in combat and felt they were being outmaneuvered by the enemy. Kelly Johnson took into consideration the suggestions of the veterans and realized the USAF required a dedicated interceptor to even the odds against the new Soviet fighter. Once back in the US in early 1952, Johnson and his team began working on a platform based purely on performance. The aircraft had to be small, light, and fitted with a powerful engine. This was the minimalist basis for the new aircraft. Over 100 aircraft configurations were envisioned, and the team ultimately settled for a design of over 12,000 pounds with a single engine. In 1953, the USAF awarded Lockheed a contract for two prototypes. The engine chosen was the General Electric J-79 turbojet, but limited availability forced Lockheed to employ the British Wright XJ-65 W-6 series. The prototypes were labeled XF-104, and work progressed rapidly with the mock-ups. The first was finished in early 1954 and flew in March at Edwards Air Force Base, California. Lockheed test pilot Tony Levere flew the XF-104 for over 20 minutes, and with only one minor issue, gear retraction problems. The second prototype was destroyed weeks later during gun trials. Still, the surviving XF-104 was accepted by the Air Force in November 1955 after further development was made to make the aircraft a more reliable platform. The missile with a man in it. Following the basic premise of developing a lightweight and aerodynamic fighter, the F-104 Starfighter had a long, thin fuselage with stubby wings that resembled more a missile than a conventional aircraft design. This earned the F-104 the nickname the missile with a man in it. The airframe was all metal, made of duralumin with a mixture of titanium and stainless steel. The elongated fuselage and trapezoidal wing design made the aircraft unique. The wings were mounted farther back on the fuselage than other conventional fighters of the time. The aft fuselage was elevated, giving the Starfighter a lifted tail and a drooped nose. To counter the high landing speed that resulted from the highly loaded wing, Lockheed developed a boundary layer control system, or BLCS, of high-pressure bleed air that could be blown over the trailing edge flaps to lower landing speeds. The Starfighter also featured a stabilizer mounted atop the fin to reduce inertia coupling. The wings were slanted downward at a 10-degree negative dihedral angle to offset the wing-on-rudder application that could occur, because the vertical fin was nearly as aerodynamic as each wing. It had a wingspan of 20.9 feet, a length of 54.7 feet, and a height of 13.4 feet, with a maximum takeoff weight of 29,055 pounds. The Starfighter became the first American interceptor capable of flying at sustained speeds above Mach 2, thanks to General Electric's 14,800-pound thrust J-79 turbojet engine and afterburner. The approximate range was over 1,080 miles, with a service ceiling of 58,000 feet and a climb rate of 48,000 feet per minute. All these features gave the Starfighter formidable performance, but it also needed to be well-armed. Limited combat. The Starfighter's basic armament comprised an M61 Vulcan 20mm gun and a Sidewinder GAR-8 missile on each wingtip, but it could also be fitted with external fuel tanks and up to 4,000 pounds of external stores in 6 hardpoints, according to the mission. There were over 10 variants of the F-104, some with slight modifications. The most relevant were the F-104B, a two-seat trainer, the F-104C, a nuclear fighter-bomber variant with in-flight refueling capability, the F-104G, a special bomber variant developed for Germany, and the RF-104G, a reconnaissance platform. The Starfighter was pressed into service during the Taiwan Strait Crisis of 1958. They were dispatched to an air deterrence mission in mainland Taiwan after Communist China launched an artillery campaign against the Republic of China on the disputed islands of Quirinoi and Matsu. Although there were no registered engagements, the F-104s achieved their purpose and helped achieve a ceasefire with China in late October 1958. Other starfighters were also prepared for combat during the Berlin Crisis of 1961, after the Soviet Union attempted to cut off Allied access to Berlin. Over 60 starfighters were airlifted to Europe in November, serving as an air superiority deterrent. The Widowmaker. In 1965, the F-104 entered service with the USAF's Tactical Air Command and participated in Operation Rolling Thunder, the massive bombardment of Vietnam, as an air superiority and air support aircraft. Soviet-made MiGs under North Vietnam's service actively avoided engaging squadrons of F-104s due to their excellent speed and aerodynamics. Although the Starfighter did not score any direct kills, it helped other aircraft shoot down enemy aircraft over the skies of South Vietnam. Over 14 Starfighters were lost in Vietnam due to SAM missiles, anti-aircraft artillery fire, and engine failures. Other U.S. allies, such as Germany, Canada, Japan, Italy, and the Netherlands, adopted the aircraft during the Cold War. However, the purchase of these F-104s was stained with controversy when, in 1975, it was discovered that Lockheed executives had bribed foreign countries to buy the aircraft. Although the Starfighter was a reliable platform, it was prone to engine failures. West Germany paid a heavy price for it. Of the 916 aircraft it purchased, over 292 crashed, resulting in the loss of 115 pilots. The casualties were so high that Luftwaffe pilots began referring to the F-104 as the Widowmaker. NASA's F-104 Starfighters. The F-104s were destined to serve with NASA after bearing the Starfighter name, and they did so under the extreme regime of high-speed flight research. From August 1956 onwards, NASA's Dryden Flight Research Center flew Lockheed F-104 Starfighter aircraft for various tests and missions. According to NASA Dryden, the agency employed 11 aircraft for the next 38 years, with the last flight taking place at Edwards Air Force Base in February 1994. In 2005, Gray Creech from NASA Dryden Flight Research Center wrote that NASA Starfighters provided valuable flight research data on reaction control system research, roll coupling, and handling characteristics. Creech notes that with the advent of the X-15 rocket-powered research aircraft program during the Cold War, research pilots required experience flying with reaction control systems to master spacecraft control and maneuverability. For this purpose, one NASA Starfighter was modified with a hydrogen peroxide thruster that provided the required experience for future rocket pilots. Creech mentions that, quote, "Durability of space shuttle thermal protection tiles was investigated in flights aboard a Starfighter, flown on a special flight test fixture through rain in moisture impact studies." NASA Starfighters also flew safety chase missions supporting advanced research aircraft, including the wingless lift body vehicle flown at Dryden in the late 1960s and 1970s. Overall, F-104 Starfighters proved to be one of the most valuable aircraft NASA has ever employed for flight research and support aircraft, serving for nearly 40 years, a distinction few aircraft within NASA have achieved. Among Kelly Johnson's many honors and awards was the Collier Trophy, given to him in 1958, and the Medal of Freedom in 1964. After retiring from Lockheed in 1975 as senior vice president, he remained a director until he passed away in 1980. Thank you for watching our video. Please like and subscribe to our Dark Documentaries channels to find more exciting content about the history of military technology. And don't forget to hit the bell icon to be notified of our newest videos. Stay tuned for more.